ซึ่งแน่นอนค่ะว่าในช่วงต่อไปค่ะเราจะมาร่วมพูดคุยกันในหัวข้อ Startup กลางปีค่ะกับ Panel Discussion ช่วงสุดท้ายของ Talk Session ของเรานะคะโดยสปีกเกอร์ที่จะมาร่วมพูดคุยกับเราในวันนี้ค่ะคือดร. Andrian Vanzel Country Head of GMS Thailand Google Asia Pacificและดร. ธีรพล ถนอมศักดิ์ยุทธหัวหน้าคณะผู้บริหารด้านนวัตกรรมและความยั่งยืนบริษัท True Corporation จำกัดมหาชนค่ะ Ladies and gentlemen, now our last sessions of our talk sessions is here. We will be talking and discussing on Startup Gang Pri and the speaker that joining us today is Dr. Andrian Vanzel. He is Country Head of GMS Thailand Google Asia PacificAnd also Dr. Thirapon Thanom Sakyut. He is the Chief Innovation and Sustainability Officer from True Corporations. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm applause to welcome Dr. Andrian Vanzel. And also please give a warm of applause to welcome Dr. Thirapon Thanom Sakyutเรียนเชิญค่ะ
Good evening, Dr. Andrian and Dr. Thirapon. So it's just an honor, my honor for me today that I have been, you know, involved and interview four doctors in one session. So first, we would like to let the people on the startups over here know more about you guys, that I can give brief introduction about yourself. So I will start with Dr. Andrian, and then we'll Dr. Thirapon.
Well, thank you very much. My job today is working for Google as the Thailand head for Google Marketing Solutions. But my real true love in life is startups, which is what I've done for almost my whole career, starting back in the early 1990s when the internet was just an idea from what we see today. So I've had the very, very good fortune of spending the last 11 years in Southeast Asia, doing startups initially, and then for the last 6 years before joining Google, running a venture capital firm right here out of Bangkok. And we built some very amazing companies across the region. You may probably know of A-Commerce here in Bangkok, but really enjoyed that experience of taking something from idea all the way through to a real business. So that's why I'm here today. I'm super excited. I love Thailand. I love startups. So I'm very happy to be here. So thank you.
Thank you, Andrian.
All right, first of all, I would like to say thank you very much for inviting me here on the stage. If you ask me about how I involved in the startup, I would say that I have been in the innovation area for more than 10 years already. Initially, I believe that the company needs startups, need innovation. But right now, when we are in the Thailand 4.0, we talking pretty much on the new sector, new kind of the knowledge, like robotics,lot of things. So the two key points that most important thing is the speed and how we get people into the organization, I mean the talents. So my job right now, I take care of the Twin Cube and also the innovation teams, the robotic teams, all the things that I'm talking about is all involved. It's become the things that we call, my job is to build the ecosystem, basically, yeah.
Thank you both of you. So,Let's pick up the word ecosystem. Now, I think Startup Thailand here, we are not now focusing only on Bangkok or Thailand. We are going to regional. So can you share us more about the, what is the existing ecosystem of Thailand right now in terms of, for example, like investor, startups, or even any other community leading up to the national aspect? So can you share us about the, what do you think about the ecosystem of Thailand tonight?
So I was lucky enough and sometimes a little bit challenging to have been here at the very beginning of what we see as the Thai ecosystem today. And it is truly amazing, I really mean this, to look at what has happened in the last 6 years, where we have literally gone from absolutely nothing, no investors, no startups, no big successes to point to, to where we are today. So just from that historical perspective, it's amazing. And I think what's changed in the last few years is we've managed to build the base in Thailand of what we need for successful tech companies. We have 4G, we have smartphones, we have social media, we have a high percentage of people with bank accounts. Like, all the basic infrastructure is there. What was missing was the financial component, the venture capital ecosystem, the mentors, really important to have the people who've had a success that can then share that both as inspiration and as support. And then we are now waiting for the next big, big step, which is where is our first $1 billion exit? So that is what we're all excited about, but it has been truly amazing to watch the growth.
So that's the path, the vision that everyone is aiming to. So as Dr. Thiraporn is a Thai and he's been in this field for almost 10 years, so what do you think is a missing piece? What has been supposed to be here in the ecosystem?
So I will not say the missing piece, but I would say that it's really a right time for Thailand to create the ecosystem. I mean, if we consider Thailand is one of the countries that have a very ready infrastructure in terms of the connectivity, the internet, and everything, right? So the key challenge is that how can we make a Thailand, which is located at the middle of the Southeast Asia, we have a very good beach, every talent, top executive around the world want to be here, right? But how can we make ourselves, make Thailand ready in terms of regulation, in terms of how we can create the way that we can engage people into the same ecosystem to work together. For example, like how we bring universities into the ecosystem, how can we make sure that the Thai startups, they embed the innovation into their idea. And most of the brilliant idea will not happen if we cannot bring the capability of different people. So that's why we try to create the example of ecosystem. So as the two group, we at the end of this year, we're gonna have the project, the big project called True Digital Park at Sukhumvit 101, which is the place that we actually bring a key element to be there, like the investor, multinational company, make sure that all connectivity is there. And of course, the startups, yeah, will be at the True Digital Park. Oh,
thank you. This is a very good project. You see at our back, it's very nice and it's very big. So, Mr. Adrian, so I heard from the recent research from Google itself, they said that the Southeast Asia right now, they have like almost $200 billion opportunity. And how Thailand, and also with the ecosystem ready at True Digital Park, how Thailand can grab this regional opportunities of $200 billion, how we can do that?
So I think that's a very good question. And I think when most of us think of answering that, we think of tech companies as the answer. But that opportunity really is for all of Thailand. It's not just for the startup entrepreneurs here. And I think it's very important to get our heads around that. That $200 billion opportunity is for all of us. So what we need to do is create an ecosystem beyond just the startups themselves. So that means the average person should have basic digital media literacy. Because if you have that, you can go onto one of the big e-commerce marketplaces as a small vendor, and you can intelligently sell your product. And you can sell your product and you know a little bit about how to market, how to capture people, how to work out the ROI. And then the moment you've got that, you go, huh, I can now export this stuff to the rest of Southeast Asia. So I think the answer to your question about how we seize this is we have to make it an opportunity for everyone in the country, not just a handful of select people in Bangkok. It has to be all of Thailand.
Wow, that's a really clear path of how to grab the opportunity of this region. So apart from this mega project of True Digital Park that Dr. Yut has been telling us, I think you have another one project that's also very interesting. As last month, we have announcing the smart visa to bring the international and foreign people to come to Thailand. This is what we call, I heard about, the Startup Grand Prix. Can you give us more detail about the project?
All right, before I explain about the concept of Startup Grand Prix, I like to give you some background of what we have been doing in terms of the incubation. We have the concept of 4I. The first one is the inspiration. As you know, that the success rate of the startup is around 10%, so we have to make sure that we have enough number of the startups in the whole ecosystem. So the first I is the inspiration. So what we did is that we have to teach the young students. We link to top universities, and we share the knowledge to them that the life of the entrepreneur, life of the startups, is not easy as you are thinking. But you have to know a lot of aspects. That the first I is inspiration. The second one is innovation. As you know, that the key success factor of the startups is to have the key innovation in there. So people cannot imitate, or you can have the very sustainable model. All right? The second one is innovation, right? The third one is incubation. That means we groom them. We make sure that their idea can launch, can implement, and can create values into the market, can solve customer pain point. And the last one is the last I is investment. That means we also have the corporate VC functions that invest into the potential company in many verticals as well. But this year is really special that for incubation program, we have the Startup Grand Prix. So it's quite similar to the theme of the Startup Thailand, which is the endless opportunity. So we try to bring potential Thai startups to see opportunity around these regions. So this year we're going to bring them to 4 countries. If we include Thailand, it will be 5 countries. So they will be explore a market opportunity, bring the right business model, but expand in more market in this region. So I'm so excited, about this project, and I want to share to all of you that we are now open for everyone with the idea can join our programs.
Both for Thai startups and also the international. You know, startups.
I was going to add to that a little anecdote about why I genuinely feel Thailand is in such a unique position to be a hub for the region. Mm-hmm. And I'll give you a real example. Imagine a younger version of me in my beautiful hometown of Melbourne, Australia. I set up an e-commerce company. And after a year, I'm quite successful. And I want to expand into a much bigger market, 20, 30 times bigger than Australia. So I come and talk to some VCs here in Bangkok. And the VC goes to me, so what did you learn in Australia? And I said, actually, it wasn't that hard. Everyone speaks English, everyone has a credit card, and I can do overnight delivery to anyone in Melbourne. It wasn't that hard. I'm now ready to take on Thailand and Vietnam and Indonesia. And any smart investor would go, you haven't really learned anything. And I think what makes Thailand so incredible is if you solve those problems, you have genuinely learned something. And in Thailand, these are all solvable problems. And then the knowledge that you have then sets you up in so much stronger a position to go out into the rest of Southeast Asia with genuine knowledge about language and payment and infrastructure that you just don't have if you're not here. So I would echo that again. I truly think the opportunity for Thailand as a hub from which to expand is unparalleled.
Thank you. Thank you for adding that. So last question, same as I've been asking for. Every startup would like to know and get some advice from you guys who have been in this industry for almost 10 years. So I'll start with Dr. Thiraphong. What would be your final advice to the startups?
Okay. I'm not sure that we can call it advice or not, but I would say that this country really needs more and more and more startups. So if you have small idea or big idea, the key point is not the idea. It's about execution. So if you feel like you are not ready, you can just start it. I will come to talk to people. Startup Thailand or many company here that they try to be the part of ecosystem, try to help everyone. Everyone here is a small part of the whole ecosystem. It cannot create by one company, by one people. So I would invite everyone to join as a friend of this very warm ecosystem. It's Thailand.
My advice would be that the hardest thing is the very, very first step. once you've taken that first step, this amazing thing happens where the universe around you, the ecosystem around you, starts conspiring with you to be successful. People will volunteer to help you. People will provide you with resources, a desk, some office space, some coffee, some free internet. They'll give you advice. The moment you take that first step, there is an entire ecosystem out there that wants to do nothing other than help you. But you have to take that first step.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Sriporn, and thank you, Dr. Adrian.
ขอเสียงปรบมือให้กับสปีกเกอร์ของเรานะคะและโมเดอเรเตอร์ของเราทุกท่านด้วยค่ะ So please remain on the stage for the photo sessions. And I would now like to invite Dr. Elizabeth Zhu, Group CTO CP Group, and also Dr. John Jiang, Group CDO of CP Group, to join us for the photo sessions.